ज्वेलरी. एवरी टाइम वी हियर दिस वर्ड वी आर रिमाइंडेड ऑफ द इंडियन हेरिटेज, हैंड क्राफ्टेड वर्क एंड द वन हु मेक्स देम. टुडे वी हैव समवन स्पेशल विद अस हु स्टार्टेड अवर ओन वेंचर, द फाउंडर ऑफ हाउस ऑफ आद्या, सायली मराठे, अ यूनिक ब्रांड नेम दैट एम्बॉडीज एवरीथिंग फ्रॉम ओरिजिनैलिटी, क्रिएटिविटी, ओल्ड ट्रेडिशन, रिस्पेक्ट फॉर नेचर एंड इट्स एलिमेंट्स. Sayali and her team aspires to work with pure elements to shape jewelry design that resonates with the universe. Be it motif of flower, ray of sun, or simple geometric transformed into a piece of art. Let's learn about her ventures, entrepreneurial journey, and what goes behind making a jewelry, and many more. If you are someone who likes Indian mythology and heritage, this is a conversation for you. And honestly, who doesn't like jewelry? सायली मराठे ब्रॉट यू इन आर्ट टर्म पॉडकास्ट सीरीज. हेलो मैम, इट्स अ प्लेजर हैविंग यू हियर ऑन अ पॉडकास्ट सीरीज.
थैंक यू पार्थ.
या सो विद दैट आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क यू, आई वुड लाइक टू स्टार्ट अ कॉन्वर्जेशन विद आस्किंग यू दैट द नेम हाउस ऑफ आद्या इज वेरी यूनिक एंड इज वेरी ब्यूटिफुल. So how does this name actually represent your brand and any thoughts behind choosing this word?
Yeah, so Adya is the original word. It's a Sanskrit word. And Adya basically means the first one or the original one. Or you might have studied Adya Sanskriti or the first culture of mankind. That is where this word comes from. And it stayed with me for a long time since I studied it in school. So when I wanted to start something of my own, I thought that this is a good name that I should use. And because, like how yoga is the original word and it got converted to yoga. And because this was to do with a lot of things with females, jewelry and accessories. And I also started with clothing in the first few days. So everybody started calling it Adya and it eventually became Adya. So that is the story of that word. And we were called Adya Originals for a long, long time. Very recently, we have shifted to a 3-floor building in Pune, which is like our house because the entire premise is Adya's premise. And that's when we started calling it House of Adya.
That's wonderful. And congratulations on your new store.
Thank you.
With that, let's actually dive into your past first. You actually are an engineer by degree, where you actually spend 10 years working in reputed companies, and then the afterlife came in your life in the form of jewelry. So before that, how was the experience of being an engineer, and how has it shaped you as an artist?
Part one of this is about education. So I come from a family where typically securing a job is very important. That thought process is used to be very prominent in my family. It's no more like that after I started Adya. But before that, my parents of course wanted me to take a professional degree and work, get a job of my own. And so it was kind of default actually. There was not that much of awareness also at that time to kind of indulge into, researching various careers. Having said that, for the longest time, I was involved in Marathi theatre and I always wanted to pursue theatre. But obviously my family was, you should get a job first and you should do your engineering first. So that's what I did. I did my engineering from Cummins College. I'm very thankful for that because that degree and later spending time with a lot of corporate companies and immediate colleagues and my superiors kind of changed the way I think, made me more organized. I started planning things really well, so I think all of that has helped in my entrepreneurial journey, and I definitely think that it brings a lot of change in you as a human also, because you start organizing a lot of things. So I'm very thankful to the education and the job that I did, the various jobs that I did. Entrepreneurship is way more rewarding because you kind of get an opportunity to touch lives with your work. So, of course, it has its own advantages.
Absolutely. Entrepreneurship comes with many ups and downs. So with that, I would like to ask you, so from shifting from engineering to being into jewelry, what was the turning point in your life and what any incident behind it?
I was in the UK for my work and I used to do a lot of beading in my part time because my job used to be done by 4:30 and I used to have a lot of time on hand, and so then I started beading. Eventually moved to opening up a page online on Facebook, and then that journey began. But I'll be very honest, I never started the page thinking that this will be a business one day. It was just a casual step, and that time it was very novel to start a Facebook page and sell something online. So that's how it started, actually. So to answer your question, there's no turning point or there's no strategy. It was just easily you can say that just a time pass actually at that time. But again, because I came from a very organized school of thoughts, I used to do it in a very organized manner. Like I had a customer list, I had follow-ups, and I kind of handled everything like a very organized company even then when I had hardly 20-25 clients.
That's wonderful. So when you actually came from having a Facebook to actually quitting your job and doing this full time, so what was that change, and when did you actually decide, okay, this is something which I want to do for the rest of my life?
No, I've not decided that I'll do this for rest of my life. I just decided that I will stop working in a company and do this right now. So rest of my life is a lot of time and I don't think I've decided anything like that. But of course, quitting your job is the most risky thing in my case. Of course, there are riskier things that people have done, but in my case, quitting the job was like a big risk that I took, because I was extremely comfortable in my job. I had spent 10 years and I was extremely comfortable in that job in terms of money, in terms of the work that I was doing. So it was very difficult. I will not say that it was a cakewalk to just quit job and start this. It wasn't as glamorous as it looks right now. It was difficult, but I think I was pretty confident that there is some meat in what I'm doing, because of the response that I constantly got from my customers or clients. And as I always mentioned that, it's a completely client-driven decision that I took to quit my job and get into Aadhya full-time.
That's wonderful. And I must say your decision was something which will inspire many of the people. With that, let's actually talk about how jewelry is made. So can you brief us about what is the science behind it, like from starting from doing a drawing to getting it molded and being fetched out of the material?
So there are two ways to create jewelry. One is handmade, one is handcrafted, and a lot of people confuse both. There are machines and tools involved in handcrafted jewelry. Handmade is completely on hand. So these are two different types of jewelry making, and the techniques are various. I mean, to execute jewelry is probably more than 100-200 techniques. But we primarily use two types of jewelry making. One is CAD based, where we do CAD drawings. Then we make molds, silicon molds, and then create our jewelry. Even if we do it on molds, at the end of it, all the finishing is with hand. The other is completely handmade jewelry, which is made by traditional artists or filigree artists who have been doing this. Their family is into making jewelry for years, which is our typical handmade jewelry. So these are two types of jewelry making techniques that we primarily used. But the initial process of initiating any kind of jewelry is the same, that you need to have an idea in your mind. It might be history inspired, it might be nature inspired, it might be a completely new concept. You have to ideate that, you have to work on that, make sketches, throw them off, make them again. And kind of after a lot of iterations, you arrive to your final collection and start working on it. And in our case, there is no choice like what metal we want to choose or not, because the metal is already pre-decided. So that's in brief about jewelry making techniques.
Yeah, as you just mentioned right now, you actually have a pre-decided metal, which is silver. So do you have any special bond with silver, or why do you actually like to work in silver more than gold or any other material?
Yeah, silver, definitely I have a special bond with silver because I am not a big fan of the gold color. Not in particular the metal, but the gold color in all. So I generally like very subtle, oxidized, plainish jewelry. And I think that's the reason I always wanted to do something in silver when I started with Aadya. But of course, silver needs a lot of experience, expert artists, and also a lot of hands-on experience on jewelry and its sciences and the history of jewelry. So I started Aadya in 2013, and it took me around 4 years to kind of get into silver. So the first collection was released in 2017 January. So it took me a long time to kind of come to a stage where I actually started making silver. But since then, we've been making silver jewelry for almost 5 years now.
That's wonderful. And I have seen your collection on your website and also on your handles. It's very wonderful. And of course, the feel of having it made by hand is something which makes it very special. So with that, I would like to ask you, so when we are making it for handmade and factory made, so what are the primary difference between both of them? And also, handmade does cost a lot more than factory made. So how do we actually look over it?
So it is an acquired skill. You won't really make out what is handmade and what is factory made in the first place. And I of course, do not have any formal education in jewelry making. So, of course, I also came on board with zero understanding of handmade and handcrafted. And I have slowly evolved into this person who now understands what is handmade and what is not handmade. So, handmade is particularly small batches. Every piece is different. Every piece is handmade. It takes a long time to make handmade jewelry. And factory made is mass manufactured. It's quick. It's perfect in its finish, and I wouldn't really prefer any type of jewelry as a maker, because I think both techniques are equally difficult and equally respectable. As a person, you might have a preference of wearing handmade or wearing machine made. My preference is handmade. I like the imperfections, I like the rawness of handmade jewelry. But there might be people who love the perfect pair of earrings, perfect necklace, or whatever it is.
Yeah, actually, for factory made, who actually like to have everything perfect and also having no flaws in it, they may actually love it. But having a feel of hand is something which is also pretty good when we look at it. It has some imperfections, but still it looks very good.
Correct. And also there is a story behind every handmade piece that you wear. So if that matters to you, then you will prefer wearing handmade.
Yeah, so could you share one of the story which you currently did, or any past experience?
So, I think what we do at Aadya, and I think what sets us apart from a lot of brands, is that we customize a lot of jewelry. So, when I say customize, it actually is based on the story of the person who's going to wear it. So, there are bands, there are rings, there are, you know, memory rings that we make. And it's a lot of handmade work on that piece of jewelry, but at the same time, it's also accommodating a story of a particular person or a relationship in that particular piece. But my favorite story in current times is one of my clients called Shardul Kadam, who got married recently, and he came to me a year back and said that I want to get a Mangalasutra done, and obviously I thought it was for his wife, and so I started sharing a lot of designs. He said, wait, it's for me, And why is it that, you know, only a girl has to always wear a Mangala Sutra and say that I'm married? When I get married, I also want to wear a Mangala Sutra and make sure that my wife knows that, you know, I'm also committed to her. And so I want a Mangala Sutra which I can wear like sport daily. And it's not like, you know, I'll wear any feminine design. I want a design that will suit my hand, my wrist. So I want a design that I can wear on daily basis. And I also want a design that will go on my festive wear or my, you know, sherwani, which I'm going to wear during the marriage, during the wedding ceremony. And so it made me think, you know, of things that I had probably not thought about before that. We made Mangala Sutra for Shardul, and then it got published on various forums, newspapers, you know, Humans of Bombay. And it was a very well appreciated story by most people. There were exceptions, but that's my favorite story. And I think I'm very grateful that I get to kind of be part of such things in people's life.
Yeah, that is a wonderful story and a great initiative by Shardul, and hope many people also adapt to it in coming future. Congrats to all of you who made it till the end. I really hope you liked our show. If you did, please leave us a review on YouTube comment box. And by the way, if you had any question which came up because of the content we covered with our guest, go on YouTube, go on Instagram, and you can leave us a comment. We will surely get back to you and help you as much as possible. Arttown.store, that's the website name, and our Instagram ID too. Find us and talk to us. We are waiting to converse with you.